Hear that?
Yep.
Nothing. No cars, no motorbikes, just country. Nice, isn't it? I've been speaking to a lot of Australians. First Australians, second, third, fourth Australians, about things that we learnt in school. And things we didn't. And it's made us realise we have a lot of BS to unlearn and some amazing truths to discover. This is stuff everyone should know about Australia. Our ancestors got to live a quiet life before those big ships arrived on our shores. Clearly things changed. Life has certainly got busier. More and more in this fast-paced world, people are trying to find connections to mind, body, and spirit. Oh. For many First Nations mob, that has always meant connecting to land, sea, and sky. It has always been this way. The dreaming is an English language term that tries to define a belief system that's shared through story, through song, through dance. It connects us to our land, to each other, to our ancestors. It's all encompassing.
So my name's Julie Jones Webb. I'm a traditional custodian and knowledge holder of the Darug Nation. So the dreaming for me is creation. It's my identity, it's my song lines, it's my country, it's my lore, and it's a place that we go back to when our time here on the land is done. It's a holistic story. It's not just one thing. It's a lot of different things to a lot of different people. We're a wee-boo-boo-boo. We're a wee-boo-boo.
Songlines are tracks that travel across the country. Some even say across the world. They are maps for land, maps for sky, and maps for self.
I think the songlines within our own country are all about our totems and our moieties, and they guide our trade, they guide our marriages, they guide our family relationships. You know, the songlines talk to us, help us travel to where we can go, where we're not meant to go. They help us navigate country.
You know those big highways and roads we travel on around the country?
Yep.
Well, many of them follow the song lines of the land and the trading tracks that our ancestors walked. Did you know that?
The roads that you see now, Great Western Highway, Richmond Road, all the main roads that we know that now have all been built on travel tracks.
I've been told by many of the elders from around the country that the song lines crisscrossed and were quite incredible. It's said that there's an emu songline coming from the Blue Mountains coming into Sydney.
Right around this country, you can experience cultural connections to place. Much can be found in country areas or major cities. In fact, almost literally in your backyards.
My name is Karen Smith, which is a good name. Lots of Smiths. I'm from the Burrungal people from Western Sydney. Well, I thought I'd introduce you to this engraving, which was left by the Cammeraygal people. Its survival is incredible. Somebody in the past saved this and protected it. So it's the only reason we have this today. And of course, now it's here for everybody to learn from. I never usually wear my shoes on a rock, but I know where this engraving is, and so I will respect it and move around it carefully. It starts with the tail down here, and then the engraving moves across the entire rock. It's really quite amazing that here we also have a figure inside the engraving. We don't really know why this is in the middle of the shark. we will never know, because the story of this rock was never told or asked about. This was for many years called Whale Rock. It is most likely a shark because it has too many fins for a whale. We know that the story of the whale is actually carved all along the coast. Sydney had the biggest art gallery probably in the world at one stage. The petroglyphs would have been along all the ridge tops, stretching all over Sydney.
Most people think that all of this, our lore, our culture, our spiritual connection, was lost the day the settlers arrived. Well, it wasn't.
We're gathered here today on Burramuttigal country at a place called Little Coogee, Burramutta meaning the eels and the eel waters. So the place that our people still come to gather, to do ceremony, to connect to, has a lot of storying around this place. It's a place where we bring our children and the place that they actually develop or begin to develop their connectedness to country. So we have a songline that we have just rediscovered. It's our eel songline. It starts down in Victoria with the Gunakurnai and the Gudishmara. It comes all the way up here to Burramutta, up to Gumbangir country. And that's a really big songline and story for us that we thought we'd lost for a long time. It's reconnected us with our neighbours. It's reconnected our children with the purpose of this place.
Every time you hear stories from other people, you learn something else that connects you further afield, and you know things travelled. It's amazing when you hear about different mobs speaking about their own country.
So the dreaming, it's something that lives within us.
So as a Darug woman, my country here, my connection to it is everything. It's the reason I get up in the morning. It's the reason I go to work every day. It's the reason I walk country with my shoes off every day. It's my identity. It's who I am. It's why I breathe. It's how I breathe. And I think this is just so intricate to my being. And I can stand on earth and I can look up at Father Sky, and I know that everything in between was put here for me and for me to learn from.
In every corner of this country, mob are keeping culture alive, making sure that connection remains strong. You do know that Australia has the longest living culture in the world. There's something special in that. Something I think should be celebrated.